All right, we're joined this morning by Aaron Conklin, and he's here to talk with us about some games this week. We're getting closer to that holiday season, so we got some of the big boys that are being rolled out right now. And the biggest one this week, probably ever, pretty much from the records it set on its first day, Call of Duty Black Ops. Talk to us about this one.
Yeah, well, obviously the Call of Duty series has been popular for a long time, and this is the latest iteration. People have been waiting for it for the entire year.
Yep.
So this one actually takes the setting out of World War II and moves it to the Cold War.
Mm-hmm.
So you play actually as a special Black Ops agent who gets sent on missions across the globe. It's the first one in the series that actually gives a voice to the main character. That's kind of an interesting twist to the single-player part of the equation.
Okay.
They've never done that before, but it really kind of gets you into it. They do a lot of interesting tricks with memory in the story, so you're kind of flashing back and forward in time, and that's kind of cool. And obviously a lot of the same things that have made the series great, you know, fantastic weapons, really excellent graphics, and good gameplay.
Multiplayer is definitely a huge part of almost any game that you buy right now, that online experience. Multiplayer, how is the multiplayer in Black Ops?
Well, it's a little different. I mean, obviously there's a high standard that's been set, so I think people are going to enjoy it. But what's different this time is that you actually acquire new weapons and armor using something called COD points.
Okay.
And you earn them by winning matches and killing folks and leveling up. And that's a different system. That's not what people have been used to. I mean, there's a lot of games that use that sort of store mentality, and we'll have to wait and see how gamers react to that.
Okay, and this is out for all the major systems, correct?
That's right.
All right, all the major systems, and price point on this $59.99, pretty standard, correct?
That's right.
All right, now we're going to move along because we're going to talk about the Xbox 360 Kinect. Now, this is PS3 has their version that they've come out with, and this is 360's version. Tell us a little bit about the Kinect.
Sure. Well, obviously, this is Microsoft's sort of grab at Nintendo's audience. You know, the Wii was the first to do motion-based gaming. This one, the big hook is that there's no controller. You're the controller. It's a camera that sits right in front of your television, and once you take a few minutes to calibrate it, you move your arms, you move your legs, and your avatar moves around, and you actually control the game without a controller. And it's actually really fun. You wouldn't necessarily think that it would be, but it works pretty well, and it's pretty entertaining. I brought along Kinect Adventures today. That's the pack-in game for the system. And you do things like you actually strike a ball and try and knock out tiles. Mm-hmm. You're white river rafting and jumping and trying to avoid obstacles. It's great, both single player and with more than one.
Now, we should be clear. We just talked about Black Ops. Now, Black Ops is not a Kinect game.
Not every
game is going to work with the Kinect. There's a special series or lineup of games that are for the Kinect.
Yeah, that's right. There are they started with 17 of them, actually, and there'll be more as the year goes on. One of the ones I would point to if people are thinking about getting into this is actually Dance Central, which is by the same folks who made Rock Band.
Yeah.
So it's an excellent party game. So the camera actually costs $150 and comes with Kinect Adventures. So.
Yeah, there's actually been a lot of buzz about that dance game that you just mentioned. All right, Aaron, we appreciate you for taking the time to come in here and speak with us, and we hope to see you back here next month.
Sounds good. Thanks.